Hello everyone, this is Just a Dad. Today I'm going to show you how to descale this Braun multi-serve coffee maker. So is your clean light on or flashing? That means it's time to descale this coffee maker. Now according to the manufacturer recommendations, they want you to buy the Braun descaling agent. Now I wasn't able to locate it. I looked on Amazon. They didn't have it for sale on Amazon. I went to the Braun website. It was out of stock. I did some research online and I found that I think you can descale it with white vinegar, the Keurig solution, or this highly recommended descaling solution off of Amazon. Now there's a heating element inside here that's going to get calcium buildup on it depending on how hard your water is. So if your coffee is not tasting the same, or if it's not tasting good, if it's not up to temperature like it should be, or if it's taking a little bit longer to brew, those might also be signs you have to descale. Now with the white vinegar, this is the cheapest, so it's $1.50 for this big jug. This is $20 for the Keurig descaling solution, and this is only $7 for this coffee machine descaler. Now this one is citric acid, this one is citric acid and sulfamic acid. I did some research online. I just couldn't figure out what is inside the Braun descaling agent. But on some coffee shop forums, I did see where some people are descaling their Braun coffee makers with white vinegar, the Keurig solution, and the coffee machine. And they're all getting very good results with those. I've been doing it for many years. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use all three of these. But I'm only going to use one for the video, but I'll show you how to use each one. The nice thing about this coffee maker is it has a self-cleaning function. So we're going to press a button and it's going to be an automatic process. First thing you want to do though is make sure your carbon filter. We don't need to be running the descaling solution through the carbon filter. Next, make sure you need the brew basket in, but don't have a coffee in or a coffee filter. Just let it sit there. You may get some little white specks in there from the calcium from the inside the coffee machine. You're going to need your coffee pot in there, your cafe. Make sure it's empty. Make sure this is on the coffee. Yeah, don't touch this during any of the process. Leave that on coffee. So let's go empty out our water reservoir. We want to start out with that empty. So I'm going to show you how much vinegar, how much of the Keurig solution, and how much of this to add. I'm going to add each one to this separately, and then I'll do one cleaning process with one of them. So let's start with the white vinegar. This is the cheapest. We're going to add the vinegar up to just shy of the 20 ounce. So just shy of the 20 ounces, right below. I don't know if you can see that. It's kind of hard to see. So there's the 25 ounces right below it. Then next, we're going to put what that is, we want 20 ounces. The reason I went down just below, we want 20 ounces. Then I'm going to put in some water. So I'm going to fill it up to the 40 ounce mark with water. So there's a 40 ounce on here. We're not going to be filling this thing all the way up. So with vinegar, this is where I would start the process. So with the Keurig solution now, the direction, you have to peel that label off to get to the directions. But I'm just going to dump the whole bottle in here. And then I'm going to fill this up with water. Now the benefits of using the Keurig solution, it doesn't smell. The vinegar does kind of smell a lot. Now I'm just going to fill this bottle up with water and add it to the reservoir. Okay, so I filled that up with just plain water. And we're going to dump it into the reservoir. And this is where I would start the process for this. So with this $7 descaler off of Amazon, I'm going to pour the whole thing in there. And again, I'm going to fill this up with water and pour it in. So again, now I just went and filled this water up, this bottle up with just fresh water. And this is where we're going to start with this descaling solution. Make sure the selector is on full pot. I'm going to turn the machine on. Now, once you start this process, you're not going to be able to to stop it. You've got to finish it all the way through. So with it on, we're going to press the clean button. That's how you set the water softness, I'm sorry. You're going to just hit the clean button. That's going to start a countdown timer. It starts at 23, the clean light is on, and we've got to let this thing finish. What it's going to do is it's going to automatically start and stop the coffee maker to brew this descaling solution through the coffee maker into the coffee pot. So the machine may sound like it's working, and then it may sound like it's just sitting there. But we want to keep an eye on when the water is completely out, then we got to do a rinse. So you can see it's counting down. So water is coming out the hot water tube. And then it alternates. Then it starts to come out the coffee maker side. So it's running the descaling solution up here. And then it's also taking that shortcut when you just do hot water. It's coming out the hot water. Because there's two places for water to come out when you're brewing coffee or you're brewing hot water. It's going to alternate between those two. And there it just switched. You can kind of hear a relay clicking. It'll switch over to the hot water tube. Now the nice thing about this descaling, it doesn't stink a whole bunch. This one hardly smells at all. The vinegar does smell quite a bit when it's brewing through there. And so what this is on 17. It's just a minute countdown. So it's going to count down to 4. When it gets to 4, the clean light's going to start flashing. And then that's when we're going to dump this out, rinse out the reservoir, and fill it up with fresh water. Okay, so when mine got to about 15, it wasn't actually a minute countdown timer, but it went right to 4. There was kind of some steam that came out of here, and now the clean light is flashing. So it's got 04. My display is missing a digit. So it's 04 and clean. I'm going to go throw out this descaling solution. Okay, so before I fill this up with water, I'm going to rinse it out and clean it out with soap and water and fill it up with fresh water. Okay, so I've got my coffee pot empty. I've got this filled up with fresh water. Again, nothing in here. And I'm just going to come up here and press the clean button one more time. This is going to start a rinse. This is an automated rinse process. So water's coming out where the coffee maker is. Right now it's coming out the coffee maker. It's doing a rinse there. Then you can kind of hear a relay click. And then it starts coming out where the hot water is. So it's alternating between the coffee and the hot water. So that's just a really nice feature how it does that. And this is counting down. Again, I filled the reservoir up to the 50 mark with fresh water. Hit the clean button again. The clean light is on steady and it's doing a rinse. Now when this is all done, I'm going to throw this out and wash this out again. I'm going to run, they suggest running 2 full pots of water through the machine on a normal brew. So I'll show you how to do that. I'll fill it back up to the 50, make sure there's no coffee in, and we'll just do a normal brew with the selector on the full pot. We'll do 2 of those to make sure we get all the taste and if there's any of that descaling agent left over. So start to finish, I'd say give yourself at least an hour. Now there, you are going to be able to do some stuff in between, but because it does kind of sit there for a little bit, and this is automated like this. And then in between, when you do the fresh rinse coffees, you can do something. But give yourself about an hour to do this. And it's definitely a good idea to keep up on top of it. You don't want, you know, if this thing gets too built up, you won't be able to ever get it clean. And it does keep your coffee tasting good and just keeps the machine working good. Okay, so when that countdown timer went to 0, it just, everything's done. The power is off. It went back to time. It ran all the water out of the reservoir, and I have a full coffee pot. So now I'm going to empty this, and I'm going to fill this back up to the 50 mark with fresh water. Okay, the water reservoir is filled back up. I've got my carbon filter back in. Again, nothing down here. You may have to wash this out with soap and water because it does get kind of some descaling solution on it. And maybe wipe this off here. This is empty. We've got this on coffee. I've got this on full. I'm going to turn the coffee maker on. I'm just going to do a light brew, which is a little faster. So I'm going to run this complete water through here. And then I'm also going to do a hot water. So I'm going to select the biggest size on the hot water. And I'm going to run a couple hot waters through here. Because there, since there are two ports for the water to come out. So I'm going to run a full pot of coffee through, of just water through the coffee. And then I'm going to do some hot waters. So it's just brewing the water through there. It looks really clear now. Okay, so it ran that fresh water through. I'm going to go throw this out and run another full coffee pot through. And then I'm also going to do a couple hot waters. So now I'm going to move the lever. I've done two fresh water rinses of coffee pots, full coffee pots. Now I'm going to do, let's do a half a pot of hot water. Turn it on. And we can turn the temperature up and hit the water. That way it just kind of rinses that other port that the hot water comes out. The instruction manual doesn't say to do that, but I just think it's a good idea. So I hope this video helps. If you've got any questions on how to descale this coffee maker, leave them in the comments down below and I'll try to help you out as much as I can. Thanks everybody for watching, and if you could, please like and subscribe.